So today we'll be starting with sets and their representation. It is the first chapter for CBSE class 11th, right? So what is a set? A set is a well-defined collection of objects. So we are talking of the collection in which an element is either a part of the collection or it is not a part of the collection. For example, let us say odd numbers less than 10. So odd numbers less than 10 are 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9. So that means it is a well-defined set of numbers, odd numbers less than 10. Similarly, let us say I want to have a set or a collection of prime numbers less than 20. So it will be 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19. So it is well-defined. That means this set or this collection is a collection of prime numbers less than 20. Similarly, we are given a quadratic equation, that is solution, that is x square plus 5x plus 4. So its solution will contain two values of x, that is x is equal to minus 1 and x is equal to minus 4. So it is well defined that there are only two roots or two values or two solutions to this quadratic equation. So it is well defined. Okay. So in last case, if I say x is equal to minus 3, minus 3 is not a part of it. Right. So this is a well-defined collection which will be describing solution to x square plus 5x plus 4. Okay. So in the same way, if I am talking of, let us say, collection of 10 best players in IPL. So first thing, this collection is not clearly defined whether I am talking of IPL 16, IPL 15, IPL 17 and so on. And secondly, 10 best players I cannot define. One will say 10 best players are A, B, C, D, E, F and so on. Another person will be having, he'll be rating some other best players and so on. So that means this set is not clearly defined. So it is not a set. This collection is not a set because it is not well defined. The members are changing as we are asking different people. Right? So this is not a set because it doesn't go for our definition. That is, a set is a well-defined collection of objects. Secondly, collection of three most dangerous animals in the world. So according to you, it can be three others. According to someone, it can be three others and so on. Again, the elements of this set are not exactly defined because they keep on changing. So from our definition of set, it doesn't go well. Next is a set of three most talented teachers in school. So you will say the most talented teachers are, let us say, Mr. Anil, Mr. Ashish, Mr. Khetan. Other will say, let us say, Miss Anupriya, Mr. Khetan and Mr. Desai. So it depends upon the different views of different people. So again, it is not properly defined. So it is not a set, right? Because the elements of this set are changing. So again, we are coming to the definition. A set is a well-defined collection of objects, right? So this should be very clear with you. Now, when we define set, again, set is a, you can say it is a complete language. So we have to define the notation. So commonly used predefined sets. You'll be encountering them in your whole syllabus. So first is N. That means it is a notation that is being used. So first is N. N stands for a set of natural numbers. Z stands for a set of integers. R stands for a set of real numbers. Q stands for a set of rational numbers. T stands for a set of irrational numbers. Z we have seen. Z plus stands for all positive integers. Right? So if I want to denote negative integers, I can use Z minus, the one thing. Right? And I can use Z minus Z plus. Okay? Similarly, I am talking of positive rational numbers, so it will be Q plus. I am talking of positive real numbers, R plus. I am talking of C, it is complex numbers, a set of complex numbers. So these sets are predefined and we can use them as and when we like. Correct? Secondly, you have seen I have written all the names in capital letters. So it is a notation that sets names should be in capital letters. It is a notation that is given to you and it is accepted, universally accepted. Now, how to describe a set? Now, to describe a set, we are having two most popular methods that are being used. One is roster form, another is set builder form. Roster form is also called tabular form. And that means we'll be listing the elements. We'll be listing the elements of the set. And secondly, set builder form will be writing some other form or format that we are going to study just now. So we'll take the examples of both of these. Hopefully it will be clear to you. So first is a roster form. Let us see the example. I have told you that we'll be listing the elements. So we are given the elements as A, E, I, O, U. So my question was, what will this one's first set show? It shows the vowels in the English alphabet. So these are the alphabets or these are the elements A, E, I, O, U. The elements are separated by the notation we'll see now. The elements are separated by commas. Plus to show this list, we have to put them in these curly braces. The braces in the sets play a vital role, right? So if I ask you the question, set of vowels in English alphabet, you'll be saying it is A, E, I, O, U, and you can name the set. Let us say it is set A, right? Now I ask you, set of all even positive integers. So you can see this is 2, 4, 6, and it is going up to infinity. So that means they are representing the positive even integers, correct? So we have written over here A is equal to 2, 4, 6, and dot, dot, dot. It stands for infinite set. So that means the number of elements, so the elements in the set may be countable or they may be infinite. So this is an example of infinite set, right? Similarly, we are given another set that is a set of prime numbers less than 7. So we are given a set named P. P is equal to 2, 3, 5. So they represent the prime numbers less than 7, correct? So these things we have written in a roster form. Roster means we are listing the elements. Second thing regarding a roster form is we can list the element in any sequence. Let us say A, E, I, O, U. I can write O, I, A, E, E, U. The sequence does not matter. Only the element should be a part of this set. So in exams, the sequence, it can be any, but they should be listed. Secondly, the element once written should not be written again. The element should not be repeated. That means I can't write A, E, I, O, U, E. No. Element should be listed once. Okay. So let us see. Second form is set builder form. So how to write the elements of set builder form or what is the notation? Notation is like this. We'll be placing the set in these curly brackets, first thing. Second is we'll be writing a variable name x, it can be y, it can be z, and then a colon. After colon, we'll be writing the property of this element, right? And then if some other bounding conditions are given or constraints are given, we'll be listing the constraints. So let us see the example of this set written in set builder form. The example one is I want to list all natural numbers, all even natural numbers. So how to write it? X such that X is an element of natural number n. N we have already defined. So that means we are having a element of this set which belongs to, E means element of, which belongs to natural number, and X is equal to 2n, and n is an element of natural numbers. That means putting n is equal to 1, what will be the first element? X is equal to 2. Putting n is equal to 2, what will be the second element? It will be 4. So I'll be having the elements of this as 2, 4, 6, 8, and so on up to infinity. So it is one way of representing the even natural numbers. So first we are writing the any variable which represent a element in this set. Secondly, I am writing the property that is x is equal to 2n comma x is an element of n, right? We are going for complete definition of x. So we have completely defined, no one can challenge this thing, correct? So complete information regarding element is given. Secondly, you can also write it like this, x such that x is equal to 2n. So that means I know this is an element and this element is equal to 2n. And what is n? N is an element of natural number. So starting with first natural number, n is equal to 1. So first element will be 2. N is equal to 2. So second element will be 4. Third element will be 6 and so on. So it is a set of all even natural numbers. So either you can write it like this or like this, it will work. So it is a set builder form, right? Next, again, we are going for a different example. X such that x is equal to n and n is an element of natural numbers and plus 1 is lesser than x is lesser than equal to 8. That means I know the element of this set is x, which is equal to a number n, and n belongs to a natural number. So that means x, the element will be a natural number definitely. But what is the constraint? The value of x lies between 1 and 8. That means it starts from 2 because 1 is lesser than x. So that means the first value will be 2 and it will go to 8. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Correct? So you can write a set either in set builder form or in roster form also. So if to write this set in roster form, how will I write it? So it will be A is equal to 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Similarly, if I want to represent a set of odd natural numbers, so it will be B is equal to X such that X is equal to 2N minus 1 and N is an element of natural numbers. So starting with N is equal to 1, so we'll be having 2 into 1 minus 1, that is equal to 1. N is equal to 2, 2 into 2 plus 1. 2 into 2 minus 1, that is equal to 3 and so on. So there are N ways of representing a set. Either you can put in set builder form or you can use that listing form that is known as roster form. Okay. Again, the example is given. In exams, you'll be asked either to convert a set or to write a set in set builder form, or given a set a roster form, you have to write in set builder and vice versa. So again, example is given, A is equal to X such that X is an element of Z and X square is lesser than 20. We have to write this set in roster form. So that means X square is, it is an element of integers first. So integers are positive and negative numbers including 0. So X square less than 20. So going with X, first element will be 0. Second, putting X is equal to 1 or minus 1, its square will be less than 20. Putting X is equal to 2 plus minus 2 less than 20. Till plus 4 minus 4 it is less than or equal to 20. So the elements of this set are 0 plus minus 1 plus minus 2 plus minus 3 and plus minus 4. Correct? Second example given is write X is equal to 1 upon 2 comma 2 upon 3 comma 3 upon 4 in set builder form. This means we have listed the elements, so they are written in roster form. Now we are writing the elements in set builder form. So it follows the rule X, that means the element, such that X is equal to n upon n plus 1. This is a property that will be followed by this element X. So n upon n plus 1. And what is n? N is the natural number. So natural number starts with 1. So what will be the first value? 1 upon 1 plus 1, that is equal to 2. What will be the next value? 2 upon 2 plus 1, that is 2 upon 3. And 3 upon 4, because n is lesser than or equal to 3, we are given the constraint over here. So in this way, you can represent the set or the collection in set builder form or in roster form. Now coming to our next topic. Again, we can go fast. It is very easy. Types of sets. First is empty set. A set which contains nothing. That is known as null set. And the notation used is either phi or we can have a empty curly braces. Right? So if the example is given like this, X such that X is an element of real numbers and X square is equal to minus 2. So if X square is equal to minus 2, I cannot get the root that is real number. It will be imaginary. So the result of this set will be a empty set. So I have written set A is equal to null set. Second notation we use is singleton set. Singleton set means the set containing only a single element, right? So if I write a set containing only a element 1, so it will be a singleton set. Another example is given, x such that x is an element of natural number and x square is equal to 4. So if x square is equal to 4, that means x is equal to plus minus 2. But x is equal to plus minus 2 and we are given that x is an element of natural number cannot be negative. So that means we are talking of plus 2. So this set will be containing only in one element, that is 2. So that is why it is a singleton set. Thirdly, countable set we have already seen. What is finite set? Finite set is the elements of which can be counted, right? Countable elements. Let us say a is equal to x such that x is equal to 2n and n is an element of natural number and n is lesser than equal to 30. So we can count the elements, that means elements in the set will be 30. Okay. Next is infinite set. Infinite set means the elements of the set which cannot be counted, right? But we know the property. So in the case of infinite set, let us say a is equal to 2, 4, 6 and so on. That means we are calling for all multiples of 2. So that means x such that x is equal to 2n and n is an element of natural numbers, right? Similarly, number of points on number line between 1 and 3. So we can have infinite number of points between 2 points on the number line, 1 and 3. We can have infinite. So it is a case of infinite set. Now coming to another definition, equivalent sets. Equivalent set means the number of elements in the set should be same. For example, A is having 3 elements, 1, 2, 3. And B is having its elements as A, D, E. So the number of elements in A is equal to 3. And the number of elements in B is equal to 3. So I can say set A is equivalent to set B. So how to write the cardinality? Because we have written same cardinal number. Same cardinal number means same number of elements. So N in bracket A, that means number of elements in A should be equal to number of elements in B. A and B set elements can differ. It doesn't bother. Next is equal sets. Equal sets means A is equal to B. That means the number of elements as well as the elements in A and B should be same. So A is equal to 1, 2, 3. B is equal to 2, 1, 3. So the elements are same, right? And the number of elements is also same. So A set is equal to B set. Now subsets. So written A is a subset of B if and only if. I have double F means if and only if A is an element of A, it implies that A is an element of B, right? So this is a sign for a subset, correct? If A is not a subset of B, that means A is not contained in B. We can write it like this. We'll write the sign of subset and it will be cut like this. That means A is not a subset of B. If it is written like this, A and this symbol B, that means A is a proper subset of B. A is a proper subset of B means B is having, let us say, one more element than A, at least one more element than A. So I can say A is a proper subset of B. For example, I'll show you the example. Written A is equal to 1, 2, 3, B is equal to 3, 2, 1 and C is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. So I can say A is a proper subset of C. Because C contains all the elements of A plus C contains one additional element, that is 4. So I can say A is the proper subset of C. Right? Similarly, A and B. A is a subset of B. I can say A is equal to B also. So A is a subset of B. All the elements of A are in B also. And all the elements of B are in A also. Similarly, B is a subset of A. I can say like this. And every set is a subset of itself. So A is a subset of A because A contains 1, 2, 3. Again, I'll be writing another element, let us say, another set, that is A is equal to 1, 2, 3. So A is a subset of A, B is a subset of B, similarly C is a subset of C. Thirdly, it is written like this, C and this symbol and A, that means C is a superset of A. Right? Superset means it contains some more element, at least one element more than A. So in this case, A is a proper subset of C and C is a superset of A. This you should remember. So example is given like this. We are having certain sets which are predefined. We are having natural numbers n, n is the proper set subset of integers, right? And then integers is a proper subset of rational numbers. Rational numbers are proper subset of real numbers, and real numbers is a proper subset of complex numbers. Okay, so this you should note down somewhere because it is important. Okay, so you can note down three things which are important from point of view of exams. Every set is a subset of itself, first, that we have already seen. Secondly, empty set is a subset of every set. And thirdly, number of subsets of finite set is 2 to the power n. This is very important. Correct? Now coming to another notation, that is intervals as subsets of R. R means real numbers. So intervals is a subset of real numbers. First is, let us say we are having an interval that is a closed interval. Let us define it. So it is written like this. We are having the boundary elements a comma b over here, and then we are putting in these brackets, square brackets. Again, the brackets plays an important role. This square means square. The meaning of this is x such that x is an element of real numbers, and all the real numbers between a and b and inclusive of a and b. So that means it is closed over here. That means a and b, these boundary elements are also a part of this subset range that is given. So it is shown like this. Let us say we are having two elements a and b. So these are also included as a part of these elements, right? Now you can see we have produced these bubbles, and these bubbles are filled bubbles, filled circles, you can say. So if filled circles are there, we'll be writing it, we'll be going for closed interval. That means they are included as a part of our range. Second is, so the example we can give is, let us say we are having a element 2, we are having an element 5. So that means all the elements on this number line inclusive of 2 and 5, they'll be a part of this result. So it is written like this, 2 comma 5. So first will be, let us say, value 2, second can be 2.0001 and so on. Correct. Next is open interval. Open interval means, again, the brackets plays an important role. For open interval, we'll be putting it like this, C. Yeah, O. This is C. C stands for closed. You can make a note like this. C stands for closed. And it is going for O. O sort of thing. So it is open interval. The meaning is, the all the real numbers between a and b, whereas a and b are not included as a part of it. So let us say a is 2 over here, b is 5 over here, so I can write 2 comma 5. So in this case, 2 will not be a 2 will not be a part of my set. It will be starting with 2 point something. Okay, next is semi-open. So semi-open, again, this stand for open, this stand for closed. It means I'll be including B as a part of my range, but not A as a part of my range. Okay, for open interval, I'll be using these open circles. That means these circles will not be filled. These are empty bubbles, you can say. So for closed, the circle should be filled, and for open, the circle should not be filled. This is the notation we are using, because again, I am saying the set is a language. So we need to know the language. Okay. Next is universal set. It is represented by U. So what is the significance of universal set? It contains all sets under consideration. So let us say we are given a set A is equal to 1 comma 2 comma 3, B is equal to 4 comma 5 comma 6. So what is the universal set of A and B? So we are having universal set as, let us say, 1, 2 up to 10. So this set will contain all the elements of A and all the elements of B. Here under consideration, the elements, the sets are A and B. Okay. So now let us go to another set. It is power set. So power set we denote like this. P A is equal to S such that S is a subset of A. It means we'll be having all the subsets of A, all the subsets S such that S is an element of A. That means subsets, all the subsets which are subsets of proper subsets of A. Okay, so let us see over here. If A is given as 1, 2, 3, so I'll be listing all the subsets. So PA means, let us say, starting with first subset. So we have already said that null set is a subset of every set. So null set. Second set will be comprising of only single element, that is 1. Next will be single element 2. Next will be single element 3. The set containing single element 3. Then we'll be having a subset containing 1, 2. Then subset containing 1 and 3. Then subset containing 2 and 3. And then every set is a subset of itself, so we'll be listing 1, 2, 3 also. So these are the sets. So how many sets are there? 1 set, 2 set, 3 set, 4 set, 5 set, 6 set, 7 set, 8 set. So these are all the subsets, and the number of subsets is equal to 8. Okay. So number of subsets in a parse set is equal to 2 to the power n, where n is equal to number of elements in A. So over here, the number of elements in A is 1, 2, 3. We are having 3 elements. So 2 to the power n. So number of elements in PA is equal to 2 to the power n. And over here, n is equal to 3 because we are having 3 elements. So it is equal to 2 to the power 3, and that is equal to 8. Similarly, we are given another question. Given a set A is equal to A, comma, we are having another element that is a set. So it is only to show that in a set I can have element, either a single element, or it can be a set, or it can be an ordered pair that we'll see later. So I need the power set. Power set means I need all the subsets of this set. So it will be, first will be a null set, then a set containing only a single element A, then a set containing only a set that is comprising of B, and then I'll be having a set comprising of both the elements. Either the elements are of same type or they are of different type. So A comma a set B. So how many elements are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. So number of elements, cardinality of this power set is equal to 4, right? So S set, it is equal to 2 to the power n. So what are the elements in A? We are having only 2 elements. So the value of n is equal to 2, so it comes to 2 to the power 2 is equal to 4, right? Other things we'll see in next lecture. Thank you very much for listening. Just share it, subscribe it if you like it.